Hey guys, thank you for tuning in to I Love You Packages, where I share all things to help improve your marriages. And today I will be sharing 7 ways to show disrespect to your husband. And I will be looking at my notes here because there's no way that I can remember it all. So if you see me looking down, that is what I'm looking at. And if you think that's a good title, that's something that could interest you, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel because there will be more videos like this. And so without further ado, let's get started. And 7 ways to show that us wives show disrespect to our husbands. And number one is not taking him seriously. So a lot of times we do not take our husbands serious. Like, we take them very lightly and we don't honor what they say. And it's not always something that we do on purpose. It just happens that way. But we should really be in tune and start to really recognize when they're speaking, when they're saying something, and not to dismiss what they're saying to us, because that is a sign of disrespect, because sometimes we miss it, right? We miss the issue at hand that they may be speaking about. We miss the task that they might be trying to give us, right? And we don't hear their heart, right? And then sometimes also when they're speaking, we hear what we want to hear instead of actually hearing what they're actually saying to us. Like, they may be asking us a quick yes or no answer, but yet we can't give them that yes or no answer. We want to go on and on and on and on about something and then answer. I think a better way to do that when they do, because I struggle with that as well, but I'm actually seeing other people, they will say, yes, you are correct. And then they will go on. Your husband may stop you because that's all he wants to hear is that yes or no. But try doing that instead of ignoring the question at hand, right? Try to answer that question first and then go into what else it is that you're trying to portray. Because sometimes it's not just a quick yes or no answer, you know, in our minds. It's not, because we have a whole lot more we want to say. So try to answer the question first so that we don't disrespect our husbands and we actually take them seriously, because men are very direct and they know exactly what they're trying to say to us and they know the exact result that they're trying to get out of us. So let's take them seriously that they know what they're talking about when they're talking to us, okay? And that's number one. Number two is we show disrespect as women sometimes in our dress code and our appearance, right? We should really, first of all, we have to really recognize the kind of man that we marry. What does he like, right? What is it that he likes? Does he like to see my legs or does he not like to see my legs? Acting, right? Am I showing enough breasts, right? Some men like to see their little cleavage, right? And some men do not. But the most important thing here is that you find out straight from your husband, like, hey, do you like this dress? Do you like this shirt? What do you think about this? It's okay to ask your husband that. Who are you trying to please? Your husband, right? You want him to compliment you. You want him to give you kisses throughout the day, come up behind you and hug you. Right? So please that man. Look the part, right? It's your husband that you're trying to please, no one else. So go ahead and respect him, right? He'll love for you to do that. Some men love for you to do that. And if he doesn't want to participate and let you know, hey, I like that, I don't like this, then you're on your own and you just do what you want, dress how you want, what you think is, acceptable. And if he doesn't like something throughout the marriage, I'm sure he will share it with you. And you just be happy to oblige. And that's it, right? So that's number two. In our dress code and our appearance, we show disrespect sometimes. So we should definitely go to the source and ask our husbands. Number three, another way that we show disrespect to our husbands is we may embarrass him at times. And again, embarrassing our husbands in our dress code. So that's why it's very important that we find out, you know, what it is that they like, if they want to share that. Sometimes we answer for them, right? We talk too much, right? When someone specifically asks your husband a question, let him answer the, let him give the answer. Unless he's looking at you or looks to you to go ahead and answer for him, right? We don't want him to look like he's incompetent or incapable of answering the question, right? So let your husband answer the question. Don't be so quick to jump in and answer for him. Give him that respect to say, oh, babe, you know, and give you the okay to answer for him, all right? And if he wants you to answer for him, do it in a humble way. Show no signs of disdain or sarcasm, right? Just answer the question as humble as you can, okay? Sometimes we correct him in public, and that's embarrassing. That's another way of embarrassing him. Do not do that. Do not correct your husband in public. There's a time and a place for that. And I hope that they honor that as well, because there's a time for that. You don't want to correct your husband in public and being dominant over him like that. It's very disrespectful. And we do not want to argue and disagree in front of people as well. Okay? So that's number three, how we embarrass them, and we do not want to embarrass our husbands. Number four is manipulation. Now that is so easy for us to do as women. Most of the time we don't even know that we're doing it, right? We know all their soft spots, we know their weaknesses, but we cannot use them to our advantage. So we do not want to manipulate our husband, okay? Number five is challenging your husband, right? A wife must know how to respectfully agree with her husband and respectfully disagree with her husband. I don't think that a husband wants a wife to always be in agreement with him. Well, I don't think he expects a wife to always be in agreement with him. But there's a way that we have to talk to our husband. And the Bible says a soft answer turns away wrath, right? And that definitely works. There is a way to communicate with your husband. It also says do not let any corrupt communication come out of your mouth, right? Everything, we don't have to agree with disagree with everything that our husbands are saying to us, but there is a way that we respectfully disagree, okay? And number six, getting to the wire here, is comparing him to other men. Right? That's another way that we show disrespect, is by comparing him to another man, especially if the comparison is off, right? Sometimes we try to help tell our husbands, oh, you should do it like this, and you should do it like Mr. Smith. Meanwhile, Mr. Smith has been doing this for 20 years, right? And he has way more experience than your husband. So that is you're comparing apples and oranges. That's definitely not the greatest comparison. So that is very disrespectful, right? And you're not showing trust, or, you know, you're just showing him something that is not right. You're making him accountable for something that is not even a great comparison, okay? And so we don't want to do that. We don't want to compare our husband to any other man. Like, we don't want them comparing us to any other woman. So please don't compare your husband to another man. Okay. And number seven, of course, is being critical, right? Criticizing your husband in front of your kids is so disrespectful, and it shows signs to him that you don't trust him, you don't think he knows what he's doing, that you got to step in and let him know, no, honey, you're not doing this right. You just make him look very, very incompetent in front of the kids, right? So don't be critical. You guys have to be on one accord when you're speaking with the kids. Hopefully you have the conversation before you go to the kids so that you are on one accord already. But if something should come up, right, and you don't agree with it, pull them to the side maybe, or wait till it's over and say, honey, and you talk about it. And then you guys go together again to your kids and you switch things up. Everything is not written in stone. Things can change over time. We're human, you know, we're not perfect. So it's okay you know, to have a discussion later. You don't have to have a big argument right in front of the kids and let the kids know that you guys are not in agreement. So they're going to cleave to one and, you know, make a big mess out of it. So do not criticize. Be critical to your husband. And that brings me to the end of this video. And thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and don't forget to check out our His and Her To-Do List Marriage Challenge Journals. The link will be in the description box, and I will see you guys in the next video.